Final Fight 3 19. travnja na splitskim Gripama i najveće borilačke zvijezde Europe. U glavnoj borbi večeri Igor Jurković protiv Iron Raula Katinaša. Ulaznice na eventim.hr.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the final fight of the main card of the Final Fight Championship number 3. Making his way to the blue corner of the ring, introducing our first fighter from Romania, Raul Iron Cardenas.
So here we are now at the final fight. And you can say that because it is the final fight and it's also the main event here at Final Fight Championship 3. They are in Split, Croatia at the Great Hall of Gripe, which is spelled G-R-I-P-E, where I come from, that's Gripe, but there's no gripe from me because this show, being hosted by Orsat Sovko, there's been knockouts, there's been a bit of drama, there's been stoppages, there's been distance fights. But we're now going into this main event heavyweight fight, and struts his way confidently into the ring from Romania. Raul Cardenas makes his way to the blue corner, and in a moment you'll see the gentleman
and
in the cap.
His opponent making his way to the red corner of the ring from Croatia, Igor Jurković.
Well, we talked about Rocky. I couldn't secure it any better. The Rocky theme plays. The local, the Croatian, Igor Jurković. And if you have a quick look at that picture there on the top of the walkway, you're not telling me that hasn't got a look of a young crow cop. And that's a lot to live up to though. Mirko Krokop, legend in the sport, who's been in the sport probably, what, 20 years, two decades? Been there with the best. I had the pleasure to commentate on the final fight, one in Zagreb last year, 2012, when he fought Ray Seppo. I got a little interview before I went into the ring, and what a humble, absolutely true sportsman Mirko Krokop is. A hero of Croatia, and out from Croatia, right firmly on the kickboxing and the MMA cage fighting circuit, that is for sure. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event, the final fight of the Final
ladies
Fight
and gentlemen,
Championships
the
3.
The last bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 rounds of 3 minutes duration, featuring kickboxing according to K1 rules. Introducing, in the blue corner, weighing in at 106.9 kilograms, with 18 victories to his name and 5 losses, from Romania, Raul Iron Cardenas. And his opponent in the red corner, weighing in at 99.2 kilograms, with a record of 45 victories and 6 losses, from Croatia, Igor Jurković. And the referee presiding over proceedings in the ring once again, Mladen Krancic.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this, and I'm going to say it one more time, this is the final fight.
I say stop, stop, you say break, main event. Punch, take your gloves and return at corner.
This is the big one, ladies and gentlemen, and again, don't blink. In the blue corner, 106 kilograms, representing Romania, and also trains at the famous, and the gentleman in the cap, I'm going to talk about him in a moment.
Judge.
Mr. Tom Harink, the famous Chakuriki legend.
Five.
So the main event, the big one, here we go. Raul Cardenas from Romania in the blue corner with the blue gloves and the orange anklets. Going southpaw with the red gloves and the black shorts, black anklets. The look-alike of Mirko Krokop, Igor Jurković, weighing 99.2 kilograms. Remember his heavyweight.
Fight.
Sends him down, a little bit more of a slip. Nice body kick. We've got the southpaw of Igor. He's just above me now on the commentary station. Solid low kicks there. Trademark of anyone who trains at the Chakariki camp. Stop. Catches the leg, takes the body kick.
What he did. Only one and one punch. It's okay.
You're allowed to grab and one punch. Ready? You're allowed to grab the kick and punch once, not step. Split warning from the referee. Solid shots there. Oof, powerful, powerful there. The heavier man there, 106 kilograms, shorter, stockier, but with far less experience. He's only had 23 fights, I say only, that's a lot. 18 wins and 5 losses. Igor Yugovich, 51 fights, 45 wins and 6 Stop. Losses. Whoa.
Timing.
Now we're talking about weight. It's not just weight, but they've just took the top rope out completely. What they're going to do here? This will be interesting. I think there's going to have to be a bit of a stoppage here. And that's what happens when you get 106 kilograms and 99.2 kilograms. Had this happen at a fight not that long ago in England. These things can happen. Wouldn't surprise me if they're going to have to completely and utterly just restart this fight.
Timekeeper. Timekeeper, please go. Judge. Timekeeper. Time. Fight.
So with Manny Sue, a quick, this does happen. Ladies and gentlemen, this is real. This is live. Things happen. Rings break. And when you've got that much weight in a fight, 106 and 99. You've got 205 kilograms in there, and it's no wonder. Oh, big shots.
Stop. You are ready? Fight.
He's complaining there, but he did turn his back. So, maybe he shouldn't have done. Easy to say for me. I'm sat in a nice, beautiful, ringside, privileged position. Well, Mr. Osat Zovko gave me the chance to commentate here on this amazing show at the final fight, Championships 3, here in Croatia, in Split, Croatia. And these two heavyweights go at it, hammer and tong. And I tell you what, they're moving like lightweights. Raul Katinas from Romania, trained by the one and only, the man under there, you can just see with a cap on in the black tracksuit with the red and yellow. Trim is Mr. Tom Harink, legendary trainer from the Chakarika camp in Amsterdam, Holland. The first pioneers, beautiful knee to take Thai boxing to Thailand, get beat, but then turn it around and produce some of the best Thai boxing outside of Thailand ever known.
Break.
So big shots coming here now in. After a fast and heavy start from Raul Katinas, it's Igor Jukovic who finished strong in that round. To me, the first half went to blue, but the second half certainly went to red. So we see some of that action here, look at that. Is where he turned his back. He's complaining, but he shouldn't have turned his back. That's what happens. Nice jumping knee there from Igor.
Judge, timekeeper.
Round two of a schedule three of this main event, heavyweights. Red corner there, southpaw Igor Jukovic from Croatia. Croatia, who to me just forged to the end of that round and took that round for me on my scorecards. Was Raul Katinas, the Romanian, came strong from the onset of round one. Slowed down the end of it. Oof, big eye kick there though from Raul. Heavy duty strikes from both fighters here. Like I said, don't blink. These are big hitters. Oof, you know what I mean?
Stop! No return. It's okay. Fight!
Fighter getting tall for spinning round, turning his back. Remember, this is K1, it's not Thai boxing where you can just kick the back or strike to the back if you turn.
Break.
Fighter has to be facing the opponent.
Fight.
Body kick overhand. Come back from Igor. Oh, good knee there. Two good knees there from Igor. Three good knees unanswered. And he's hurt him to the body. But the Romanian puddles away at the head.
Break.
Raul, relentless with the hands. Igor, solid knees, and again another one. That's going to take some gas out the tank. Replies with an inside low kick, two of them. Heavy shots again. Oh, the shin comes around the side of the head, but he took a shot. This is an absolutely awesome main event. Living up to its expectations. Two big hitters here. Slamming. Bamming, banging away. Who wants it the most? If the knee goes in again.
Fight.
Just less than a minute left of this second round. What a desperation with that swinging right hook. He looks a little bit tired now. Roll. Knee goes in again.
It's worked really well for Igor. Both fighters feeling the pace, and understandably as well.
Fight.
This has been absolutely solid. Blood comes from the nose there of Raul. Look a bit of blood as well. Claret coming from Igor's nose too. Showing both fighters have had success in the face. But it's the knees to me, the ones that are doing the damage. And a big right hand, two right hands. Can't take the fight yet out of the Romanian. There's the bell. What a good fight. He gets my applause. Both of them get my applause. Absolutely outstanding. But what a good fight to finish with. And two good fights. Two good rounds, sorry, in this fight. Some of the action there, look at that. You can see the heavy left up. Turns his back. Referee warns him. Well, fighters really want this, you can see. Absolutely hammer and tongs. Missing with that right. Takes a jab. High kick there, just going right up there, upstairs, nearly taking the lights out. You can tell both of these guys want this bad. This has been a great heavyweight match.
It's okay. All right.
This is the third and final round, ladies and gentlemen, here at Croatia. At the Great Hall of Gripe. Split Croatia. Orsat, Zovko, and Fight Channel. Ooh, sweat flies, Rocky style. This has been a great fight, absolutely. Speed, power, everything. The high kick goes in, the knee goes in, the reply.
Fight.
Let's see how much has been taken out of these two, because it's this third round that will really test both fighters' metal and gas tank. And I think those knees are the one, to me, that have been denting the gas tank off Raul. Katinas, the Romanian, who certainly has come here to fight against the local Croatian, Igor Djokovic. Testing times for both lads. Both of them dig deep. Oh, that knee, two knees. Been absolutely systematic, clinical. Good front kick as well. The back leg, the back knee, where a lot of power's coming from that back leg. But the Romanian solid torsos took them shots. I'm telling you now, you'll feel them in the morning. Look, another one goes in. Worked well with that. Oh, but big right hand. Good knee, two knees come in. Oh, big shot, sweat flies right over me. Rookie style, this is fantastic. Whoa, big eye kick coming from the Romanian. The knee goes in, and it's still a minute and a half left. This is OMG stuff. Wow.
Fight.
Wipe the sweat off my program in front of me. This is unbelievable. Both fighters have given us an absolute outstanding heavyweight match. Look at this. There's still a minute left. The knee comes back, but the Romanian is still there. He's pushing forwards. Driving, pushing. Igor Djokovic must be thinking, what have I got to do to get rid of this Romanian? How do I send him back to Romania? And that knee goes in again. Blood all over the face of Igor.
Right.
Showing that Raul has had success. And he continues forward, urging him on by the great legendary trainer, Tom Herrick from Chakarike, the Romanian who trains with him. And again, he still comes forward, pushing. Big punches come in.
Big.
15 seconds remaining on the clock. Both fighters, absolute gladiators. This is an amazing fight put together. Orsat Zovko, what a matchmaker you've done here, young man. This is it. Whoa, big eye kick goes in. This is fantastic. Look at this. Boom, bash, fish, bosh, ding, dang, do. Way! What a good fight. That was outstanding. That gets my vote. The cameraman at the side of me are laughing at me because I've got super excited. Oh, that was brilliant. And I'll tell you what an outstanding fight. Ladies and gentlemen, come on, tell me that isn't kickboxing at its best. Here's some of the action. Shin to the head, knee to the body, low kicks, high kicks, thrills, spills, knees, big hooks, everything but the proverbial kitchen sink. Boom, over the top of the head, into the head, round the head, everything's in there. This is kickboxing at its best, K1 styling. Look at that is what it, look at that, sweat and blood. You couldn't write this. That was amazing. Wow. Whew. What a great fight. Ladies and gentlemen, how is this going to go?
The judges have made their decision. The winner by unanimous decision, fighting out of the red corner from Croatia.
Well, they've given it the Croatian. Is it those knees? I want to say unanimous, but there again, it could be because it could just be 1 point off each judge. A lot of people mistake that word unanimous. It sounds like a landslide. Don't think the unanimous can mean that. It could just be won it on, okay, by the slightest 1 point margin. Well, the Rocky theme plays, and rightfully so, because you're not saying that couldn't have been in a Rocky film. Ladies and gentlemen, can I just wrap this up nicely?
Igor, another fantastic fight at final fight. Last year, Freddy Kemayo, now Raul Katinas. Really impressive. You participated in another barn burner here at final fight.
Yeah, I have to. Raul je super borac. Moram se izbjegavati tuču na blizu. Tako je bio plan raditi koljena. Ne se opuštati u razmjenu udara sa njim što je bilo na njegovom terenu. Zahvalio bih se ovoj divnoj publici koju nisam nipošto stio razočarati. Nažalost, 15 dana prije borbe, nešto manje u stvari, pukla mi je šaka na treningu. Tako smo je dobro bandažirali. Jer ponavljam, nisam stio razočarati ovu divnu publiku i svu ovu organizaciju koja se toliko trudi za održavati takve evente unutar Hrvatske. Hvala.
Hvala tebi, Igore. Još jednom se oduševio, čestitke. Igor said that he had a broken fist 15 days before the fight, but he still managed to fight. He said that he wanted to evade the in-fight of Raul Katinas, to evade his hooks and to use his knees, which he did very good.